Wrestling fans, the following feature confrontation, it is set for one fall or TV time remaining. Introducing first, he'll be accompanied to the ring by the First Lady of WCW, Medusa, from Robbinsdale, Minnesota. Weighing 249 pounds, the United States Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Cut the music. What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat, out of shape, inbred idiots, keep your mouth shut while I take my robe off and show you what a real sexy man is supposed to look like. Hit the music.
Well, as Ravishing Rick Rude honors us all with his presence, Michael Hayes, what were you telling me during the commercial break about this guy? He's got some big news on this Saturday's WCW Saturday Night.
Yes, he does. He didn't want to go on camera and officially say it, but he told me in confidence, and it's not for your ears, but I'm going to go ahead and tell you, that he's got some very special information on Ron Simmons, going to exploit something.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Tokyo, Japan, weighing 246 pounds, Kensuke Sasaki.
The undefeated Kensuke Sasaki, a real powerhouse. One of the brightest young stars internationally in the sport of wrestling. He certainly got Ravishing Rick Rude's dander up at Halloween Havoc when Sasaki was one of the officials, along with Harley Race, in Rude's quest to become the NWA champion against Masahiro Chono.
You call that officiating, what he did at Halloween Havoc?
Well, he and Harley Race were both... up straight for the power. He is a powerhouse. He is indeed that. Low center of gravity. Arm drag takeover. And he got real high up on the arm there. Working on that wrist lock there of Ravishing Rick Rude is Sasaki.
But not only is he a powerhouse, he's very, very quick.
Well, the kid started martial arts training at the age of 5. He started amateur wrestling training at 6. He's been wrestling and competing all his life. And Ravishing Rick Rude hammers at the back, again trying to drive the oxygen out of Kensuke Sasaki. Rude with those forearm shots. That's an illegal maneuver. As Sasaki is in trouble here in the early going of this challenge event.
This has been such a great show, and to end it up with this match is fantastic. Ho!
Look at the strength of the young man from Tokyo. Sasaki has also mastered many of the great submission maneuvers. We've seen that Masahiro Chono, who will meet the great Muta at Starrcade, utilize the STF. He's helped teach that maneuver to Eric Watts, and Sasaki has gone through those clinics as well.
Oh, you had to bring up Watts' name, didn't you? I'm going to ruin his homecoming in Louisville Wednesday night. Look how Sasaki keeps so far away his base. Where Rude, it's hard for Rude to make a counter. See, he's keeping his distance.
The thing about the Japanese athletes that we see compete here in WCW is that they are all so very, very fundamentally sound. They start competing, as I said, at such a young age. And look at Sasaki, continuing to pressure that wrist, taking it against the grain. This is the art of leverage. We're seeing it right here. Look at keep a close look on the hole there. Now, Rude's going to try to create some separation with Sasaki back in the corner. Irish whip to the far side. Sasaki very quickly moves out of the way and avoids the contact from the United States heavyweight champion Ravishing Rick Rude. And Rude, certainly a banner day for him yesterday as Sasaki continues to turn up the burner on that hammerlock.
And I think you'll see a repeat of what happened yesterday at Starrcade. Rick Rude will beat Ron Simmons again.
Well, he is extremely confident of up unseating, perhaps upsetting Simmons. Both men back up to a vertical base, and it's ravishing Rick Rude who regains the advantage by temporarily blinding Sasaki, and then comes with those heavy blows to the back of the head and the neck. Double thrust right to the throat, and Sasaki back to that wrist lock.
Well, you got to think that Rude wants to weaken that neck, and the powerhouse that he is, he's going to have a lot more chance against the Rude Awakening than your normal guy.
Rude anticipated, and anticipated wrongly. Cross body by Sasaki, not known for his aerial abilities, and again, that high arm drag takeover where he put so much pressure on the elbow, and now goes back to the wrist. Again, look at the pressure, taking it against the grain. It is a sport of leverage, and Sasaki is certainly, for this inexperienced as he is, has really mastered it to this level.
Oh, the referee almost caught that one.
Sasaki counters ravishing Rick Rude.
All right, let's get him down.
Well, the referee is counting, and Rude shoves Sasaki away. And comes with a high-impact move, that clothesline. Sasaki, remember, is undefeated here in the United States. He is in the top 10 internationally in the ranking sanctioned by New Japan Pro Wrestling. And I know he'll be watching because he'll be in the Omni on the 28th. He'll be very closely monitoring what happens between Chono and Muda for the NWA title at Starrcade. Snapmare takeover, and now ravishing Rick Rude for the first time is being able to put more than one offensive move together and control this small bundle of power. Small in height, but not small in strength and in power.
No, but what he's going to do here, he's got to weaken the neck. Sasaki has a very strong neck. Not much of one, but it's a very strong one. As you see, that head just sits on the shoulders.
Rude would like to be able to weaken the neck, utilize his Rude Awakening.
Which is not his only weapon.
Certainly isn't. You know, he won every match but one in the NWA tournament this past summer by using the knee drop off the top rope.
And he used that yesterday.
Which was an illegal move now, but the referee didn't see it. But be that as it may, Rude now up on top here to take a chance after flooring Sasaki. Caught him with that fist off the top, hooks the leg, could be over here, and Sasaki able to kick out. And he is up in a lot of trouble here, obviously. And Rude continuing to focus on the neck with this modified version of the camel clutch, making Sasaki use all the strength in his neck muscles.
You know, we see Medusa over at the bottom of the screen. She's being uncharacteristically quiet.
Well, this is a very intense situation. Hey, they knew when they signed the contract that Sasaki has yet to lose. This kid is hot. And Rude, obviously got to be thinking about Ron Simmons on the 28th of December, is ripe for the upset. And if Sasaki wins this matchup, he's going to be right in line for United States title match. And I don't understand this bumping and grinding stuff.
Well, of course you would. Look at Rude's body and look at yours.
Well, there's a good point in that. But this is wrestling. He's not a Chippendale, is he?
Well, no.
Nobody's
no,
putting the dollars in his boots or something.
What he is United States champion and soon to be world heavyweight champion. A good concentrated attack.
Rude with that reverse chin lock, sitting in the small of the back, putting tremendous pressure on the lower back of Sasaki. And this is certainly one way to not allow Sasaki to use his power.
Exactly. And see, he's sitting further back on Sasaki than the usual application to keep him from using those powerful legs and get up like he's trying to now.
Sasaki trying to get back to a vertical base, and Rude puts him right back down. A lot of impact on the lower back and spine.
Now, ain't that nice of him to root him on like that?
Oh, yeah, it's extremely, extremely benevolent. Rude, great upper body strength, and he's certainly utilizing a very sound attack here.
Yes, he is. See, he pulls on that. It stretches the back. It stretches the neck up under the chin. It's a very effective maneuver.
I know Rude is extremely pleased with what he thinks. He outsmarted Ron Simmons and with that Medusa Paul Orndorff situation a few weeks ago on WCW Saturday night. Last night, for those of you that saw, and we showed most of you again exactly what happened. He used the Rude Awakening to secure the victory over Simmons in that tag team match.
Whoa.
And right there, Sasaki sensed what was coming, perhaps, able to move out of the way, avoid it once again the contact. And Sasaki, those martial arts chops, he went for the drop kick. Again, he is not an aerial competitor. That is not his forte. He took a chance. It did not pay off for it. And Rude now, with that height leverage advantage, has a sleeper on Sasaki.
And you can see right now, he's going to try to weaken the state of Sasaki, which will make him prime picking for the Rude Awakening and the end of the winning streak.
Again, ravishing Rick Rude, negating the power of Kensuke. Sasaki Rude is a great tactician. Very, very technically sound. And when he meets Ron Simmons, he will have a vast experience advantage. He has wrestled, quite frankly, in more main event matches than Ron Simmons has in Ron's brief career.
And not only that, he's wrestled past the 30-minute time limit mark many more times than Ron Simmons.
Good counter move there by Sasaki. Just crashed into Medusa here, and Sasaki inverted atomic drop.
Hello.
Watch that clothesline. There it is. Sasaki comes with the power, and he comes with it with tremendous velocity. The United States champion in trouble.
Ho!
Sasaki with another slam. Elbow drive. Lateral press here. 1, 2.5. The United States heavyweight champion, ravishing Rick Rude in a lot of trouble. Sasaki now will try to put him away, it would seem. Once again, we'll take another chance. And this one pays off. The double axe handle to the head.
Oh.
And a lateral press. It's another near fall. And Rude is really in trouble here. He's got to reach way down. And Sasaki going back up top.
Maybe one too many times here, Jim.
Well, if he hits this one, it could certainly be over. And Medusa distracts him. Rude shakes the ropes, and Sasaki loses his balance. Rude now with a Rude Awakening, and it is that sudden. It is that sudden with a Rude Awakening. He hooks the leg, and Sasaki's winning streak has come to an end.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the United States heavyweight champion, ravishing Rick Rude.
Well, what a weekend it has been for ravishing Rick Rude. He controversially beats Ron Simmons with a Rude Awakening. And now he ends the winning streak of Kensuke Sasaki with perhaps the most sudden and devastating move in WCW.
Well, here we look again. Medusa's just trying to give him instructions, knowing her Japanese, trying to be a sweetheart, which she is sometimes. Sasaki messes up, gets caught on the top rope, then the Rude Awakening. And that's what Ron Simmons is worrying about right now.